What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today, we've got kind of an interesting video. I've been wanting to do this for a long time. If you guys didn't know, the National Corvette Museum Library and Archives provides a service where if you submit to them your VIN number, they can provide a copy of the build sheet and window sticker of your car. So that's pretty cool because a lot of these cars don't have those things still. Most of these cars do have a build sheet hidden somewhere in the frame of the car, but I'm sure most of you don't want to take apart your whole car to find an original build sheet. So this is an easy way and relatively inexpensive to get a copy of your build sheet as well as the original window sticker. So I went ahead and submitted both VIN numbers for the C5 and the C4, and I just got them in the mail. Haven't even opened up the envelope yet. So let's go ahead and take a look. So here's what the website looks like. And I mean, you got build sheets, window stickers, even got dealer brochures for most years, if they still have them available. Otherwise, you can look on eBay and stuff for brochures. They're all out there. You can get the Corvette Black Book. It's got some good information in that, but honestly, most of that information is on the internet nowadays. So yeah, go ahead and scroll down. You can see here's kind of what an example of a build sheet looks like. And they've got some information down here, some frequently asked questions. And you can get these build sheets in paper, you can get them laminated, you can even get them printed on like sheet metal. They've got all kinds of options available, different ways you can do it. You can do tempered glass. I mean, you can really go crazy. Brushed aluminum. So that's pretty cool, all the different options. And here's kind of where you fill in all of your information, you want. And then obviously you fill in your VIN number and your information down here about the car. So here's the envelope I got in the mail. It says National Corvette Museum Library and Archives, Bowling Green, Kentucky. So let's go ahead and open this thing up. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and open up this envelope. So I optioned for the paper laminated build sheets and window stickers. So here we go. This is for the C5. This is for the C4. And let's see, we got the window sticker. That's the window sticker. Okay, so that's for the C4. And this is for the C5. Okay, this is some pretty cool stuff. This is archaeology, like I was saying with the C4 spare tire a few days ago. So we've got the C4 info here. We've got the C5 info here. Let's go ahead and look at the window stickers. So on the C5, this is what the window sticker looks like. Or looked like back in 1997. It's a 1998 model year vehicle. And let's go ahead and see. Total vehicle price was $41,089, and that included a $565 destination charge. So the base price of the C5 back then was $37,495, and then you got all the options listed here. Six-speed manual transmission was $815. That's interesting. I thought the manual was the standard transmission, and the automatic was the pay-for option. So that's interesting. I did not know that. Transparent roof was an option. That was $650 back then. It did have a CD player. Ooh, $600 option. Air conditioning electronic dual zone. That was a $365 $1 option. So there was two different air conditioning HVAC options. You got the dual zone, then you got the standard climate control. Six-way passenger power seats, that was a $305 option. Standard was just the driver's side had electric seats, and the passenger side was just manual operation. Obviously, I don't have the factory seats anymore, so they're all manual, so I don't really care about that. Did have the memory package, $150 option. Fog lamps, $69. That's also interesting. I did not know my car had fog lights. So they're probably buried somewhere behind the Veroram intake. I'll have to take a look at that. That's good to know. See, this is why it's good to have this information, because you never know. You know, the cars are 20 to 30 years old now. So it's good to have this information. Rear compartment cargo cover, $50. That's that spaghetti strap thing that most people just throw in the garbage because it's absolutely useless. Color keyed front floor mats, $25. Carpeted inserts, and then you got the emissions, and the tires are no charge. So some pretty interesting stuff on the window sticker here. Estimated annual fuel cost was $1,000 back then. That's interesting. Factory fuel economy ratings was 18 city, 27 highway. That's probably pretty accurate for, you know, as the car was when it was stock. If you guys saw my video where I totally redid the interior carpets, the carpets were really nasty, and they were actually a reddish color, and I was really curious about that, and it turns out that this car did come with Firethorn red interior. And the interesting thing about that was the seats that were in my car were black, but the carpets were this Firethorn red. So the seats that were in the car when I purchased it were obviously not original. And then obviously I changed the carpet out to black because I think it looks better. The Firethorn red look. Some more C4 parts just showed up, so we'll get to that here in a little bit. But back to the Firethorn interior. That was actually a pretty rare color option. If you haven't seen that, I'll put up a picture of what that looks like here. So it's a little bit darker than the bright red interior option. It was not that bright red that you're probably used to. It was a little bit darker, but mine was just absolutely destroyed. I mean, it honestly looked like somebody tried to dye it black. It was so dirty. So I just changed it all out for black anyways. So interesting, this car was a white with red interior car from the factory. But there you go. Original sticker price, $41,000. So now on to the C5 build sheet. This is what the factory puts in the car when it rolls off the assembly line. And as you can see, there's a lot of stuff going on here. A lot of numeric and alphabetic codes. You really, to fully understand what this says, you need to have kind of a VIN code decipher, and that stuff is available online. It'll tell you what every single one of these numbers means, but it does have some interesting information on here. It does say who the car was delivered to originally, and that was Bobby Lehman Chevrolet in Columbus, Ohio. Interesting thing I just looked up, that is now called Mark Wahlberg Chevrolet in Columbus, Ohio. So shout out to my friend Rick Conti in Ohio. Interesting that my car came from his home state there, so that's pretty cool. And it'll tell you, you know, it has the memory package,
Power seats. It did come with the base seat option. So the C5 did have two seat options. There was the base option and the sport bucket option. So that also solidifies my understanding that my car did not have the factory seats in it when I bought it, because it had the sport bucket seats. Actually, I have the passenger one sitting over here. I'll show you.
So this was the passenger seat that I took out of my car when I originally bought it. And the difference between the base seats and the sport seats was this little opening right here. The base seats did not have this. The sport seats did. So just a little bit more info mining on my car. And I think it's somewhat solidifying something that I've been curious about and have, I think, known all along. I think my car was a flood car at one time. Even though it has a clean title, I don't think it was ever reported as a flood car. Just from everything that I've done with the car, you know, I've touched almost every nut and bolt on that car at this point. There's corrosion in some weird places that you wouldn't expect. The carpets being as filthy as they were, even if somebody was just absolutely disgusting, I don't think the carpets would be in that kind of condition. Not having the original seats, all that kind of leads me to believe that the car was probably in a flood situation and somebody rebuilt it and never claimed it on their insurance. So some other information here, it has some of the other options, the clear roof, the fog lights, just some other stuff, but some really good information on here. It's really good to have this. So here you can see the window sticker and the build sheet. Both say Bobby Lehman Chevrolet on them. So that's pretty cool. So now we're going to move on to the C4. This is the window sticker. As you can see there, it says 1988 Corvette hatchback. Interesting to know that this car has been local its entire life. It came from Courtesy Chevrolet in the Phoenix, Arizona area. That's actually right by my wife's office, so that's kind of interesting. And it shows the VIN number, Bowling Green assembly here. Here's kind of all the standard things. And then here's all the options. So yeah, kind of cool. It's got the bright red paint was original. I'm trying to get it so there's no glare on there for you guys. There you go. Six-way driver power seat. That is for the driver's seat only. Red leather buckets. Those have been redone since they were original. Radiator cooling boost fan. $75 option. Not sure what that means. Comes with a L98 5.7 liter V8 at no charge. Well, that's pretty nice of them to give me that at no charge. Automatic transmission with overdrive is also no charge. Don't know why they don't have that on this side. Did come with the Bose sound system. Heavy duty radiator was $40. Again, I don't really know what that means. And the bright red paint. So gas mileage, 16 to 25. Original price was $31,483. So yeah, even back then, that was not a cheap car. So just something to note that a few people have commented on my C4 videos. I did say that I am going to be replacing the Bilstein shocks on my car. So I've done some research, and yes, I know the Z51 package on the C4 came with Bilsteins, but it turns out that the base suspension also came with Bilstein brand shocks. It's just a different spec shock. So obviously I will be replacing the shocks on the car, and they are going to be the OEM Bilstein shocks. So here is the build sheet. Very similar to what the C5's build sheet looks like, actually. It's just a little physically smaller. As you can see, courtesy Chevrolet, that's where it was shipped to, charged to. But yeah, it's got pretty much all of the same coded information above here.
So that is going to do it for this video. One final just comment about these build sheets. Interesting fact, if you guys didn't know, all of the Corvettes that have been built from Bowling Green Assembly, I'm not sure if the cars from St. Louis had this as well, but every car that's been built in Bowling Green has a hidden build sheet somewhere in the car, usually in the frame rails of the car. I know in the C5 it's in the frame rails, but obviously most people don't want to take apart their entire car to get to this stuff. So it's really, really cool that the Corvette Museum offers this service. I don't know of any other car in the world that you can do this with. So that's really cool. It's really cool to have this info. So I hope you guys enjoy this video. I hope it was informative for you. And if you guys are interested, I will put a link to the National Corvette Museum's website in the description below this video. If you got a Corvette, I highly recommend getting your build sheets and your window stickers. It's just a cool little thing to have. So yep, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And more C4 content to come, so stay tuned. We'll see you guys later.